So most people are familiar with the mud at the bottom of the lake as a gooey mess, but really it's a treasure trove of information we can use to understand the lake itself. Sediment continues to build up in the lake 24 hours a day, 365 days of the year, even under the ice. Included in this mud are the remains of biological organisms that have sunk to the bottom after they died. There are chemicals like metals and contaminants from a huge range of sources. So almost everything that happens in the lake and in its catchment leaves some trace in the sediment that we can use to reconstruct and infer how the environment has changed over time. So when we extract the tube of mud, we can study how it has changed over time by looking at the different layers in the profile of the core. And we have ways of dating how old the mud is by looking at the radioactive isotopes that are left in the sediment core. In collaboration with researchers at York University, we're looking at the remains of microinvertebrates in the lake, zooplankton called cladocerans. Cladocerans are an important part of the aquatic food web. They're a key food source for small fish, and they're important grazers on the algae. They eat all of the algae in the lake. In addition, we'll be looking at the larval remains of small flies called chironomids. Some chironomids have the ability to tolerate low or no oxygen conditions in the lake, and so we can use which species are available and present in the lake in order to track oxygen changes over time. So the layers of mud in the sediment cores we take from Lake Scugog act as the pages of a history book and allow us to reconstruct the changes in this ecosystem.